to introduce myself. My name is Yang. Many years ago, I lived in the palace of the great king, Mangkut of Siam. The king wished to be a modern king, to learn all there was to learn of Western culture. So he brought to Siam a school teacher from England. This is the story of my school teacher, Mrs. Anna, and the powerful king of Siam, and how their meeting changed many lives, most of all their own. Our story begins 30 years ago in 1862, when I was just a young girl. The ship is called the Chow Phya. The ship has sailed from Singapore up the Gulf of Siam and is now making its way slowly along the winding river that approaches Bangkok, capital city of Siam.
Shivering in my shoes, I strike a careless pose.
royal children. He has no right to pry into my personal affairs.
I know I wouldn't, ma'am.
I don't like that man.
In foreign countries, it's best you like everyone until you leave.
Your Excellency, I had no idea you spoke English.
It is not necessary for you to know everything at once. You come with me now. Your packages will be brought to the palace later.
But I'm not living in the palace.
Who said?
The king said. Says. The king has promised me a house of my own.
King does not always remember when he promises. If I tell him a great promise, I make anger at him. I think it's better to make anger at him about much larger matters.
I'm sorry, Your Excellency, but I came here to work, and I shall take nothing less than what I have been promised, and that includes a house of my own.
You will tell King this?
I will tell King this.
It will be a very interesting meeting. You come to palace now.
Your Excellency, I have made a bargain and shall live up to my part of it. But I expect a bargain to be kept on both sides. I shall go with you now.
To the palace?
For the time being.
Teach the children of mothers who are in favor with the king. Ah, doesn't?
Madame, you have English books I can read?
Of course I have.
I wish most to read a book called The Old House of Uncle Tom, written by American lady Harriet Beecher Stowe.
A woman has written a book?
A very wonderful book, Your Majesty. An American book. All about slavery.
Huh? President Lincoln against slavery too, no? Me too. Slavery very bad thing. Lady Ted, take them to your quarters and prepare all children for presenting to school and ship.
Your Majesty, in our agreement, you...
I think you'll teach my wives too. Those who are in royal favor.
I shall be most happy to teach your wives, even though that was not part of our agreement. Speaking of our agreement, reminds me that there's the matter of my house.
What else?
The house you promised me.
You teach in palace, you shall live in palace.
If that's how it must be, then I'm afraid I will have to return...
Ha! You will stand there to meet royal children.
But your Majesty...
The royal princes and princesses.
Look, the way to Siam.
Siam's not so small.
Look, England is even smaller than Siam.
Before I came here, Siam was to me just like that little white spot. But now that I've lived here and met the people of Siam, I'm beginning to understand that.
You like us?
I like you very much indeed. It's a very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought, that if you become a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught. As a teacher, I've been learning. You'll forgive me if I boast. And I've now become an expert on the subject I like most. Getting to know you.
What?
What? How can school be so unscientific?
Your Majesty, we have had a I was describing snow to them, and they refused to believe that there was such a thing.
Snow?
Snow.
Ah, yes, from mountaintop.
From the sky.
From sky to mountaintop. I have seen pictures. Switzerland, land all white with snow.
That's right, Your Majesty.
Who does not believe this? Do not ever let me hear of not believing school teacher, who I bring at such great expense. £20 a month. Sterling. Children must learn, teacher must teach. Not instruct silly English songs, home sweet house. You just do remind me of breaking promises I never made.
Your Majesty did promise me a house, a brick residence adjoining the royal palace. Those were your words in your letter.
I do not remember such words.
I remember them.
I went to the remembering. Who is king here? I remind you, so you remember that. I do not know of any promise. I do not know of anything except that you are my servant.
Your Majesty, indeed. I am not your servant.
Your mother has bad manners.
Well, your father has no manners at all.
Lewis! Your Majesty, if you do not give me the house you have promised, I shall return to England.
No, please not go. Do not go back to England. We learn. We believe school teacher. I believe in snow. Do not let her go away.
I let her do nothing that is not in my pleasure. It is my pleasure you stay here. Palace!
No, Your Majesty.
Why wish you to leave these children? All who want to be so extraordinary.
I do not wish to leave them. I love them too. Quite extraordinary. But I cannot stay in a country where a promise has no meaning.
I will hear no more about this promise.
A land where there is talk of honor and wishes for Siam to take her place among the modern nations of the world. Where there is talk of great changes, but where everything still remains according to the wishes of the king.
You will say no more! No more!
I will say no more because I have no more to say.
Thank you.
apologize.
Your Majesty.
I accept.
Your Majesty, nothing can alter the fact that in my country, anyone who makes a promise must—
Silence! Do you not have any respect for me? Why do you stand over my head? I cannot stand all the time. And in this country, no one's head shall be higher than mine. In my presence, you shall so conduct yourself like any other subject.
You mean on the floor? I'm very sorry, Your Majesty. I shall try my hardest not to let my head be as high as yours. But I couldn't possibly work that way. Or think.
You are a very difficult woman, Miss Anna. But you shall observe care. Head shall never be higher than mine. If I shall sit, you shall sit. If I shall kneel, you shall kneel. Etc., etc., etc.
Very well, Your Majesty.
Is promise?
Is promise.
Good.
Is there anything Your Majesty would like to discuss?
Why should I discuss important matters with women?
Very well, Your Majesty. Your Majesty, I was wondering if there has been any news from abroad.
Huh? Their news. Certain English thieves who wish to steal my country call me a barbarian.
Barbarian? But this is a lie.
False lie. British diplomat now on his way to see for himself. Diplomat Sir Edward Ramsay.
Edward?
You know Sir Diplomat?
I knew him many years ago, before I was married. What have you decided to do about the situation?
Do you guess?
Well, if someone were telling a lie about me, I should do my best to show them the truth.
Yes, that is what I decided to do. But how? You guess how.
Well, my guess would be that when Sir Edward arrives, you will entertain him, in an especially grand manner. Then he will return to England and report to Queen Victoria that you are not a barbarian.
Naturally. This is what I have decided to do.
Of course. Put your best foot forward. This is just an expression, Your Majesty. It means to be at your best, to show from your most beautiful women, your most intelligent men.
But shall it be proper for English diplomats to see my women with no shoes on their feet? Shall it be proper for them to put their best bare feet forward?
We shall dress them up. In European fashion, how many women can I sew for me?
All women in kingdom. Come, come, come. Everybody, wives, etc., etc., etc.
How much time shall we have?
That depends on how many ports you stop into. Let us say we have 1 week.
1 week?
That time the whole world was created. Moses said. Are there any details I did not think of so far?
You must give him a dinner. A European dinner.
I was going to.
And a ball with music and dancing. And we can present a play. Tap Tim has written a version of Uncle Tom's Cabin for the children to perform.
Huh? A theatrical performance? In such a splendid evening, you will see that I'm not a barbarian. Light up, light up, light up! For the next week, the men and women of my kingdom shall work in preparation in arrival of diplomat. What?
Majesty, it is the arrival of Sir Edward Ramsay.
Now?
He must have come directly.
But
no stops.
But we are not ready.
Not ready, Your Majesty?
I have planned the best idea I ever get.
Still, we can do it, Your Majesty. We shall put Sir Edward to bed.
And tomorrow morning, we shall send him on a sightseeing trip.
We shall start now, this minute. We have only 18 hours, but...
First, we shall ask help from Buddha. Bow, bow, bow! Bow!
Oh, Buddha, give us the age of your wisdom.
She instructed in the style of European dress and supervised the cooking of the European dinner. Everyone was eager to assist Mrs. Anna so as to make a proper impression upon the British diplomat. Lady Tang was especially helpful, knowing how important this evening was to be for our father.
Thank you.
of us aren't happy.
Why unhappy? What greater honor than for a young girl to be in the palace of kings?
Your Majesty, if Tupton is caught, shall she be punished?
Naturally. What would you do for a king?
I believe I would give her a chance to explain. I would try not to be too harsh. Your Majesty, of what interest to you is one girl like Tupton? She is just another woman, as a bowl of rice is just another bowl of rice.
Now I understand about women.
Your Majesty, I don't know if I can ever make it clear to you. We do not look on women as just human females. They are, well, take yourself for instance. You're not just a human male.
I am king!
Exactly. So every man is king and every woman is queen, when they love one another.
This is a sickly idea.
It is a beautiful idea, Your Majesty. We are brought up with it, of course. But try to imagine a young girl in her first dance. It's very exciting. When you're young and sitting on a small chair, your eyes cast down, terrified that you'll be a wallflower. Suddenly, you see two black shoes, a white waistcoat, a face, and it speaks. We've just been introduced.
found on Chinese sailing ship. It is believed she is running away with men who bring her here from Burma.
Dishonor! Dishonor!
Susanna! Your Majesty, I beg of you, do not throw away everything you have accomplished tonight. This girl hurt your vanity. She hasn't hurt your heart. You haven't got a heart. You never loved anyone. You never will.
I show you!
I cannot believe you are going to do this dreadful thing.
Am I
you
king?
Are a barbarian!
Am I king or am I not king? Am I to be disrespected in my own palace? Am I to take orders for an English school teacher?
No, not orders.
Silence! I am king as I was born to be. And so you can be governed my way. Not English way, not Chinese way, not French way, my way. Barbarian, you say? There's no worse barbarian than a weak king. And I'm strong king. Strong, you hear?
Take her away. You have destroyed King. Now he cannot be anything that he was before. You have taken all this away from him. You have destroyed King.
The next boat that leaves the port of Bangkok, no matter where it goes, I shall be on it. Give this back to His Majesty.
I wish you have never come to Siam.
So do I. So do I.
Yes, Louis. I like him very much. Very much indeed.
In fact, I can stay only a few minutes.
I told you, but not of my own free will. Why is your head above mine? I'm not afraid of that which is happening to me, Miss Anna. You teach your loved one. Your loved one teach me. Make believe you brave is always a good idea.
You are brave, Your Majesty. You are very brave.
I have something belonging to you, Miss Anna. The priest put it on. Please wear it always. Everyone, come in.
Thank you. performance. I just want to say a few mazel tovs to a few key people before I hand over the mic to Sharon. The parents know for sure how many hours and days and months of hard work this fabulous performance took. There were many, many wonderful people involved, and I know Sharon again will thank all of them, but I have to just highlight a few. First of all, and foremost, the incredible 48 fabulous middle school students who are the best. We hope to see our sixth graders and seventh graders and those fifth graders out there on stage next year, and for the eighth graders, Broadway. Absolutely. It takes a very, very talented, outstanding director to identify and nurture the talents of our students. Maddie Tesher, thank you so much for an incredible job again. What can I say about Sharon Sesson except we're very, very blessed, which I told her before. This is her bar mitzvah year, an alumni parent who comes back year after year after year. Thank you so much. 13 more years at least. Somewhere. She's always, always, always here for our children. Many hours of dedicated work. Thank you, Anand. Fred Saltzman and Richard. Fred, thank you again. Fabulous job on the sets. Thank you so much. Tori Botwinick, an alumni of a school who is a teacher herself, comes back year after year to help us. Thank you so much, Corey. Our student stage managers, Anna Parks and Michael Green, where are you? Okay, they're not coming out yet. Okay. Thank you again, and we hope to see all of you next year. And now I'm going to hand over the mic to Sharon.
As we have. Every year we get to this last show, and I know that's it. I was getting a little teary-eyed. It's really been wonderful. We started auditions in June and went through the tears then, and we had a talk before we started this last show about plays and auditions and leads and chorus, and I think these kids really learned an awful lot about what makes up a good production. It's not just the leads, it's not just the chorus, it's not just the spots or the special effects. It's all of them put together. And each and every one of their smiling faces actually makes such a difference on the stage. The last 2 years, the numbers of the kids auditioning was really failing. And I'd spoken to Molly Chapter, who works with has been working on the play with me for many years. And we were thinking, should we do the play? Is there a really interest in the play? Should we continue? I said, you know, let's give it another shot. Let's see what happens. And came June, we had about 55 kids audition. We didn't know where they came from. The enthusiasm of the children and the parents was overwhelming. We haven't had so many children try out in such a long time. And you parents were wonderful. Many of you volunteered to help, many of you called me, you wrote me notes, and we really do appreciate every one of your, you know, offers to help, because it just makes it a lot easier. I think now after 13 years, we've gotten down to a science. But with every year, it's just more special than the next. And many parents come over and say to me, oh, this was the best. This definitely was the best. But every year is the best. And for this year, and for these kids, this was absolutely better than best. And for me, it's 13 years since we've started the play, and it's very special for me. I can't believe that it's been 13 years since my oldest daughter said to me, Ema, why don't we do a school play? Duh, did I ever think I'd be doing this forever? No. But it's wonderful, and just enjoying the kids just makes it all, every bit of it worth it. I thank you for sharing all of your children with us. It's really been wonderful. And I do have a few thank yous, so bear with us. Maddie Tesher, our director, Tori Botten. Maddie's been with us now for the last few years, and it's just wonderful to work with her. And I was away for a few weeks, and her and Tori and Anand Goldman really held down the fort. Anand, thank you for everything. And I'm trying to help school. And she's here for everything your children need. And I don't know what we'd do without her. Our set builders, Fred and Richard Saltzman. And
Fred!
Our beautiful scenery was painted by Jane Simonson. The sound. Our dear friend Jim Albrecht, who comes back every year. I call him in July with the date to make sure you won't be busy. Lights, my son Ari Sasson, an alumni. And on spots, two alumni, Rachel Adler and Jason Eisler. Costume and makeup, my sister Sue Garalick, Michelle Eisler, Linda Gersley, and the committees. And I want to thank the Gersley family again for sponsoring all the noshes for the kids and all the rehearsals and the food outside. We're very lucky to have families like that in the school. They're always there to help. Our beautiful play bill this year, Judy Klein and Nancy Sheff. And ticket sales, Nancy Goldman. Thank you, Nancy. Our others behind the screen, behind the scenes, Uri, my husband, Jim Gersley, Jay Lender, Fred, Eka Adler, I don't know who she is. I'd like to thank the Wiener family for donating these beautiful shirts. I would like to thank the alumni parents that are here this evening and alumni students that come back to enjoy the shows, to support us, to participate. It's just wonderful to see so many alumni parents and the kids. And I would like to tell you that some of the kids that are graduating already came over to me and they asked me if they could come back and work with me again next year. So it really is something special that we have here. They just don't want to leave, and it's great that they're willing to come back, and we want them back, and I welcome them with open arms. I'd like to thank our stage crew, but I think they have something planned. So our backstage crew is Adam Hawks, Michael Green, Richard Saltzman, they're having fun. I thank you all. I hope I didn't leave anybody out. If I did, I apologize. Hollywood Video is doing our tapes. If anybody still would like to purchase tapes, they're for sale. And I thank you again. The children will be going in the back to change, and please don't rush them. We have to get all the costumes together, and give us about 15-20 minutes with the kids. And again, I thank you all very, very much. But one second, sorry. Okay, everyone up.
Sticking with the play for 13 years, because it wouldn't be the same without you.